In 1902, Philip Lennard did an experiment on photoelectric effect. This experiment supports the failure of the classical wave model of light in explaining the photoelectric effect. Let's discuss the contradiction between the classical wave model and the experimental results. When light is incident on the surface of a metal, we predict from the classical wave model that if the light intensity or the power is sufficiently high, electrons are liberated, whatever the frequency of the incident light. Now, let's move to the experimental results. A green light is incident on this metal. We increase the intensity of this light. Even though the intensity is increased, no electrons are liberated from the surface of the metal. But why? Electrons are not liberated when the wavelength of the incident light is greater than the threshold wavelength of this metal, regardless of the light intensity.
Now, let's give another contradiction. As the light intensity or power incident on a metal increases, electrons should be ejected with more kinetic energy, since the energy is proportional to the average power. But according to the experimental result, using this PHAT simulation, as the intensity or the power of the incident light increases, the speed or the kinetic energy of each electron does not change. So the kinetic energy does not depend on the power or the intensity of the incident light. Only more electrons are liberated when we increase the power.
Another contradiction between the classical wave model and the experimental results. At low light intensities, the photoelectrons need a measurable time interval to absorb energy before they acquire enough kinetic energy to escape from the metal. Now, observe the experimental results. The electrons are liberated almost instantly from the surface of the metal, even at very low intensity. The photoelectrons are emitted from the surface of the metal in less than 10 power minus 9 seconds, even at very low light intensities.